In this topic for this session, we'll see various working capital management policies. Now, why do we have working capital management policy? To manage our funds effectively, right? Similarly, a company can either follow a conservative policy, moderate policy, and aggressive policy. Now, conservative working capital policy means is that we minimize the risk. How? By maintaining a higher level of working capital. Now, working capital management policies is all about how much amount of working capital you need to have. So, conservative approach is all about you should have a high level of working capital to minimize the risk. This type of working capital policy is suitable for those companies who have seasonal fluctuations, like seasonal products for them. Similarly, have a moderate working capital policy. This policy refers to the having a moderate level of working capital at all the times. This amount of working capital is related to the moderate level of sales, so directly related to your sales as such. Similarly, it means that 1% change in working capital is equal to 1% change in sales. So moderate is directly related to sales and you keep amount of working capital. Similarly, we have an aggressive working capital policy also. This capital policy is very risky and it's applicable to have a high working capital policy in case of high level of sales. So it does not match up with the sales level at all. Similarly, an aggressive working capital policy says that when you have a low level of working capital all the time, it does not match with the sale at all. So conservative was having a high level, moderate was a balance. Aggressive means whenever sales happen, we'll manage it that time. So against the high level, whenever you get a huge order, when you have a high sales level, aggressive policy does not match with that at all. So it is having a low level of working capital, so that when emergency happens, you won't be able to meet it as well. But depending on companies to company, they can either have a conservative, moderate, and aggressive working policy. Let us do a small illustration now. After we are clear now, as compared to sales, as you can see the graph as well, how current assets are proportioned in conservative, moderate, and aggressive, right? In short, if you see, conservative means what? Having high amount of current assets. Moderate means a balanced amount of current assets, not too high, not too low. Aggressive means having a very low level of current assets. You don't want to unnecessarily block your funds in your working capital. But how does it impact the overall functioning of a company? Which management policy is the best? Let us do a small illustration to make it more clear now. For example, a firm has the following data for the year ending 31st March 2013. Sales is 1 lakh at 20 each, so you get 20 lakh as the amount of sales. EBIT they have given to you is 2 lakh, that is earnings before interest and tax. Fixed assets are given to you as 5 lakh. The three possible current assets for the holding of the firm is 5 lakh, 4 lakh and 3 lakh depending upon the working capital management policy, aggressive, conservative or moderate. Assume that the fixed assets level is constant and profits do not vary with the current asset level. The effect of the three alternative current asset policies will be what? Let us see how does it impacts in moderate, aggressive and conservative. So what we'll do, we'll compare the three policies, we'll go one by one, we'll see the conservative, we'll go to moderate and we'll see aggressive. Let us fill in the blanks what is given to us. See, sales will remain the same. We follow conservative, moderate and aggressive. So sales will be 20 lakh for all of them. EBIT will remain the same, 2 lakh for all of them. Current assets they have given you for conservative is 5 lakh, moderate is 4 lakh and aggressive is 3 lakh. So if you see now how much are the fixed assets? Fixed assets are the same that I told you for all the level. Fixed assets are 5 lakh. So fixed assets are 5 lakh for all of them. Current assets are changing. Can you find out the total assets? Yes. Current assets were fixed. Add the fixed assets. And conservative 5 lakh plus 5 lakh will give you 10 lakh. Moderate will be 4 lakh plus 5 lakh will give you 9 lakh. Aggressive 3 lakh plus 5 lakh will give you 8 lakh. Now can you find out your return on total assets? How do you find return on total assets? EBIT divided by total assets, right? So 2 lakh divided by 10 lakh into 100 will give you 20% for conservative. For moderate will be how much? 22.22%, that is 2 lakh divided by 9 lakh into 100. For aggressive will be how much? 2 lakh divided by 8 lakh into 100, which gives you 25%. So if you see return on total assets is what? In aggressive policy it is the highest and the least in your conservative. Let us continue. What else we can find? We can find current asset to fixed asset ratio. So if you see current asset to fixed asset ratio for conservative is 1:1 because current assets are 5 lakh and fixed assets are also 5 lakh. Moderate is 4:5, that is 0.8, and for aggressive is 3:5, that is 0.6. So if you see, in case of conservative, your current asset to fixed asset ratio is the highest because you're keeping high level of current assets and is the lowest in your aggressive approach. But whatever calculation we have done, it shows that the conservative policy does what? It provides higher liquidity to the firm, but lower return on total assets. Similarly, if you see aggressive policy, what does it just? It gives higher return, but lower liquidity, and this is very risky. Similarly, if you see moderate policy, what it does? It gives higher return than conservative policy, but lower than aggressive policy. This is less risky than aggressive policy, but more risky than conservative policy. So when you compare the various policies, what do we find? It's all about determining the optimum level of current assets. The firm should balance the profitability, solvency, and minimize their total cost. Total cost, in a sense, cost of liquidity and cost of illiquidity. In short, this is what the various approaches are all about, and depends upon company to company what they find feasible to follow conservative, moderate, or aggressive policy.